guys, it's Angelina and Dima from Okinawa World from GR11 Trail Spain. The night was very warm and calm, the terrain was a bit uneven, but otherwise we had nice sleep with the sheep bells and no other sounds.
For today we can see that the weather is sunny from the very morning and probably can be hot, but on the weather forecast it says that it's like pretty moderate, it's gonna be like 25 degrees, which is nice, and probably with the cool wind, so we hope for that, because for today we have another quite a big plan, not so much kilometers, 13 kilometers only, right? But we can see that the terrain is like that, very hilly. So here in the Basque country, it's, the GR goes like that. When before, in the high mountain part, we had like major uphill and then major downhill every day. And here we have several small uphills and downhills. And it turns out that it's no less challenging if you repeat it many times. So yeah, we expect it to be quite challenging again. And today we won't pass any villages, probably just follow the hills and the forest. So let's start the day. It's already 8 a.m. and it's about time to get on the trail.
Now the trail has been quite flat with only minor ups and downs.
Alright, so we are enjoying this kind of foggy weather. It's humid again in the morning, like at the tops of the hills it's always like going to be fog in the morning, right? And yeah, hiking with the sheep right now. We've been talking now about how the places got very difficult for the stealth camping because all we see is the slope and quite steep inclination, so this is like very challenging to find more or less flat spot. We're not talking here about the perfect flat spot, but even the potential spots, we're just always browsing around, looking around for them. Just like we are getting down and there isn't any. So yeah, we're just kind of concerned, you know, about the next night that we're going to spend and what we're going to find. It's 10 a.m. now and we see further on the trail we have left only 8 kilometers, but with the 3 ups and downs to do, which we don't know how steep it's going to be and also how warm it's going to be. So yeah, it's still like we're going fine, kind of early, but it's okay because we don't know how much time it will take us to do.
There are lots of crossroads at this part of the trail, so it's easy to confuse the route.
For some reason, lots of crossroads, there are no sign whatsoever of GR. So yeah, you just have to check out your map constantly because there is plenty of roads and paths and everything. So at this point we have made all our major uphills and downhills. We just had a little bit of break in the shade, having our lunch, and now we have left only around 3 kilometers, maybe less. We'll see how it goes. Still the water fountain and the spot where we potentially would like to stop, because close to the water, as you guys know already, it's very important for us. There is access to the water source. So far so nice. The trail has been following the farm roads, quite easy, moderate to easy ones. And today also we've been cherishing, not only today but these days, we've been cherishing the idea of seeing the ocean from one of the tops of the hills, probably in the clear weather, you know, with clear sky, as is today. But unfortunately it's not the case. Like, all we can see are the endless hills and mountains, and probably it's not this point. Maybe in 2 days before arrival we will see that. This would be awesome. So as usual happens, in the last couple of days we faced the problem again with finding the camp spot, with the flat camp spots, because they are all hilly and it's extremely difficult terrain to find a flat camp spot. So yeah, we had to stretch further, like to do an extra uphill from the water source where we initially planned to stop, and now we don't know, we need to stretch even further, we think. And all we see is a slope, and oh my god, this is like one of the most difficult places we've ever encountered for the camp spots. So yeah, but hopefully we'll find something. Pray for us.
We're at the camp spot now, which we think it's a neglected road. That's why more or less flattened, and all the rest of the terrain is very hilly.
Yeah, right, so we had to stretch a bit further, then we had to go back to this place because we didn't find any better. This is like extremely difficult, as we said, like one of the most difficult places, I think, right, for stealth camping.
But the day overall it was good, with mostly easy routes, and we did our distance fairly quickly.
And if it wasn't for this challenge of finding the camp spot, it would be like perfect nice days when we arrive early and have time to rest and stuff and enjoy the nature as we like. But yeah, it is as it is, and now we have to just, we think we'll take a shower, right? And then set up a tent, cook our dinner, usual stuff. And well, probably we'll show you what we cook today. There's nothing special, but still. And yeah, so see you there in the tent and tomorrow on the trail. Bye, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment below to let us know how you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more hiking adventures. Don't forget to hit the bell to stay notified about every new video. Also visit our website walkingnatureworld.com to find detailed hike reports with pictures and maps. Have a beautiful day, everybody, and until very soon!